think about one of the most popular spreads for your toast. Margarine, well these days, combined with butter to make it more spreadable. But what's margarine? Well, it's canola, an oilseed grown in those glorious yellow fields in Australia's wheat belt. We're the second biggest exporter in the world. So, what's canola? Well, the word gives you a hint. The ola, well that's oil. And the can, well that's Canada. Because the Canadians invented canola back in the 1970s using plant breeding techniques. So, let's get to the trade war, shall we? Last December, in Vancouver, Canada arrested and detained Mingren Zhao, daughter of the founder of Huawei, the giant Chinese mobile phone company.
In 2012, Huawei began a concerted effort to steal information about a robot that T-Mobile used to test mobile phones.
So you might wonder, what has a mobile phone got to do with margarine? Well, in a tit-for-tat for Meng's arrest, China found reason to ban Canadian imports of, you guessed it, canola.
We're going to roll up our sleeves and work with the Chinese officials to demonstrate that canola should continue to flow safely from Canada to China.
Except, remember, Australia, the world's second biggest canola grower, around 3.6 million tonnes every year, and around two-thirds of that gets exported to the world, mainly to Europe, but some of it to China. Well, China, though they're not happy with us for banning Huawei gear in our 5G telecom rollout, well, they want more of our canola because they like spreads on their toast too. But there's a problem. The drought that blighted our farmers also crueled our canola crops, which grow mostly in the wheat-growing areas.
Honestly, I think we've gone past the numb stage. We've gone past the crying stage, and now we're just rolling with it.
So as you spread your toast this morning, just think about our farmers, the trade wars, and the Chinese people and their toast. Because you see, it's got more to do with you than you actually think.
Yes, we're very pleased to say Ross Greenwood is out of the bathrobe, he's out of the kitchen, and he's joining us now in the studio. Ross, good morning.
Good morning to you.
Very nicely illustrated there. Obviously, though, there are serious issues here, and in every war there are winners and losers. How is Australia faring overall?
Well, at the moment, what I'm trying to explain to you is that Australia, if we had the canola, would be a winner from this war, because while Canada's not sending that canola across, we could be sending that product to China, and as a result, we would be winning from the war. My worry is about when peace breaks out between the United States and China, because I suspect Australia, which has its unique advantages to the world, could very well lose in terms of it. Think about, say, for example, I was talking to one of Australia's biggest cattle producers last night. They're concerned about the deal that might happen between China and America that might freeze Australian cattle farmers out of the Chinese market and bring the American farmers more advantage. Then think our wine industry, which is booming right now. So we've got big wine exports going to China. They love it, right? But the whole point about it is Americans make wine. So who's to say that the Americans don't actually end up sending more wine? So it does have a real impact on our economy and indeed on our agricultural industries and many other industries besides.
But China and the US are at absolute loggerheads, aren't they?
They are, yeah. But remember, they're negotiating. Mm. So this is all about brinkmanship. This is about Donald Trump and his style and the fact they're negotiating hard. But what they're negotiating for is a peace. And what they're really trying to get to is a point at which, number one, Donald Trump thinks that he's got a good deal and that President Xi in China thinks that he's got a good deal. Now, when that happens, remember, Australia could be the collateral damage. So we might be winning from the war. We could end up being potentially losers from the peace unless we have got our special place in the world.
It is a fascinating state of affairs. Just quickly, butter or margarine?
Look, generally butter, a bit of Lurbach or something like that. Something spreadable, you know?
It's got to be spreadable.
Look after the farmers, I think, as well.
Very good message. Yeah. Very well said.